Right now, an international manhunt underway for a Russian national suspected in a double murder. New York City police say Nikolai Rakosi hopped a plane to Moscow after fatally stabbing his girlfriend and her daughter. Meg Strickler is a criminal defense attorney. Anita Kay is a former prosecutor. They join us live to talk about this and another case. Last year, Russia was urging the United States to sign a bilateral extradition treaty. And we haven't done it. There is no extradition treaty with Russia. Could this guy, Anita, get away with it?
He very possibly could, especially if he's got connections and money in Russia. I mean, he's not a U.S. citizen. So to track him down, he could get lost, not only stay in Russia, but go somewhere else and get lost. But Russia, you know, isn't going to send him back. So it's going to be difficult to get him here in the U.S.
Yeah. You know, Meg, what about that? It was just a few months ago that Russia was fighting a U.S. effort to extradite a Russian drug dealer by the name of Victor Bout, an infamous, nefarious character. And they also fought the extradition to Great Britain of the man charged with poisoning Alexander Litvinenko. So, I mean, the Russians aren't going to help us here, are they?
No, I really don't think we're going to have any help here. We do maintain diplomatic relations with Russia, but I really doubt that we're going to find him ever again. And that's why he took off as quick as this happened. He was out of here.
So Anita, what do we do?
Well, Interpol's got to get involved, got to be on the lookout for him and flag him. Because the thing is, it might not be 6 months or even a year from now, but as we know in the U.S., there's no statute of limitations on murder. And as people get comfortable on the run, and he is Russian, he may feel comfortable there, he may take a trip somewhere else and get him in another country. He may even come back to the U.S. thinking, oh, I've got a different passport, they're not going to catch me. So it's unlikely he's going to stay in the same place for the rest of his life. And Interpol, they've just got to be on top of it and on the lookout for him, and we may get him.
All right. Want to talk to you both about a different case. This one actually brought to our attention by Jenna Lee, my colleague. And it's tragic, and it's troubling legally. A pregnant woman tries to commit suicide by eating rat poison. She survives, but 6 days later, she has a C-section, gives birth to a premature baby girl who is suffering from seizures after she was born because of the rat poison. The baby died 4 days later. There is the woman, and now that woman is charged with murder and faces up to 85 years in prison if convicted. Now, Meg, 36 states have fetal homicide laws, but generally they don't apply to the mother. Some do. Is there any reason why she should not be charged with murder?
There's a million reasons why she should not be charged with murder. This is a horrible precedent. If they try to convict her on this, it discriminates against all pregnant women. And that way they can't seek any help if they're facing depression. That's what this was, depression, which is a disease. This was an unborn child. She tried to kill herself. This is a very scary, scary, scary thing. If this was any other disease, she would be hospitalized just like with diabetes or whatnot. Very scary. Very discriminating. It's all pregnant women.
But, you know, Anita, whenever there's an intent to harm someone, it's a crime. Shouldn't that also apply to fetuses?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I look at this very different. There's no one who's going to say this isn't tragic. Tragic for the mother and tragic for the baby who died. But the thing is, you know, reading these articles saying, oh, this is going to make abortions go up, things like that. You know what? She could have had an abortion if that was the issue. Now, I do think that in this case, there may be mental health issues, and perhaps there would be a not guilty by reason of insanity, or there would be a plea worked out because she does need mental care, or she's not even competent to stand trial.
Right.
But the fact is, she knew she was pregnant. Regardless of the depression issue, she had an obligation to care for that unborn child.
You're saying no, Meg.
And
why?
And she didn't.
No, and what about all the other mothers out there who have other issues, health issues, you do not get proper prenatal care. This is very scary. I'm sorry to keep using that word scary, but this is giving me a chilling effect as I sit here
but
thinking
Meg,
about it.
In some states, mothers can be charged with child abuse if they take illegal drugs during pregnancy.
Exactly.
How is this any different?
But what about when they have diabetes or if they have, you know, I can't think of all the different medical conditions one has when they're pregnant. This is going to create anybody who cannot. I mean, she was depressed. Your hormones are crazy when you're pregnant. She was depressed.
Anita,
so she should have gotten sentenced her.
Anita, last word.
She should have sought help.
Insane.
She should have sought help. And you see women who give birth, and especially teenagers who are killing their babies, this is not any different than that. She knew what she was doing. She could have sought help. She was an adult. She could have sought mental health help.
She wasn't in her straight mind. That's why she was depressed.